Today I'm going to show you how I make a hybrid fitted. So the first thing you're going to need is your diaper pattern. And with your diaper pattern, you're going to cut out an outer layer. I'm using a cotton knit. You're also going to need a hidden layer of fleece. I'm using a DWR polar tick. I think it's a 300 fleece. You can also use just a basic polyester fleece. I do have a video comparing the two so you can see the difference between the two. But this is what I'm using with this particular diaper. And then you will also need a third layer of cotton velour. And that is going to be the inner layer. It's nice and soft and absorbent. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take my hidden layer of fleece, and I'm going to attach. I'm going to line the two up, the outer fabric and the hidden layer of fleece. I'm going to line those up. I'm going to take some basting spray. I'm going to spray it so that it'll stick and I won't have to worry about it moving. And then we're going to go add the snaps. I will be back in just a moment. I got my top layer of knit attached to the hidden layer of fleece so that they are more or less one piece. That way I won't have to worry about them moving around when I add the snaps and when I sew or serge. Now I'm going to add the snaps, and for this particular diaper I'm going to do a fold down rise instead of a snap down rise. So right now I'm just going to do one layer of snaps right here. Next step after the snaps are added is to flip it over and I'm going to line up the inner part of the diaper, the cotton velour. To take my basting spray again. I want to line this up and I want it to stay in place. So I'm just going to lightly spray the tabs just a little, get it lined up. That doesn't have to be absolutely perfect. Okay, do the same to this side. Now, I don't want to spray right here because this is where the elastic is going to go. And it's really hard to get the elastic to place properly if there is basting spray. Now this basting spray is temporary, so it will wash out, which is good. That's what we want. Let's spray the front panel. And once again, we don't want to spray right here because this is where the leg elastics are going to go. Although if you really wanted, you could spray just a tad, maybe right in the middle, to help that stay. You don't have to use basting spray at all. You can pin it or use binder clips. This is just how I prefer to do it. It helps me keep keep everything lined up without the worry of pins or clips getting in the way. Okay. So, now that that is done, now we're going to go over to the sewing machine and we're going to make the casings and add the elastic. Okay, so here we are at the sewing machine. I am going to make the casing for the back elastic first, and I'm going to start where my tag is, my label. Now, I'm going to I basically line it up to where it has 3/4 of an inch. So I come in about 3/4 of an inch. And let me get my sewing machine set up properly. Sure that your inner cotton velour or inner cotton or whatever you happen to have is lined up. Okay, my stopping point. Take it out. I've got my back stitch, or my stitch for my back elastic, rather. Stops here, starts here. Now I'm going to come do the same to the leg elastics. So I have all of my casings made. Now the next thing I'm going to do is add the elastic. And the way I add my elastic is I take one point, I open up the little flap, and I add it in between the inner piece of fabric and the hidden fleece. So I'm going to put it just like that, and then I'm going to sew it down. Now, I'm basically going to hold the diaper on this end. I'm going to stretch the back elastic, and I'm going to pull it as tight as the elastic will go without getting overly tight. And line it up with the other side of the casing. Now, okay, once I get it lined up, push it in as far as it'll go. Down too. So it'll look a little funny, maybe like it's not gonna work, but once we get all of the elastic in and serge around it, then it will work perfectly. Okay, now I'm gonna take the elastic again and I'm gonna put it in between for the leg. And you want to make sure that you have enough extra when you sew down on your elastic isn't going to pop out. So I'm going to sew right here, exactly in line with my casing, but the end of my elastic is right here. And when you're sewing down, the elastic, you should only sew the width of what the elastic would be inside. So you don't have to sew all the way to the end. You should have a little bit of space for the edge when we come and serge, and you're not serging over or cutting off any of the thread. Okay, now I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to hold one end and pull it until I reach the other end of the casing. And just kind of guesstimating here. Now, if you download my pattern, you won't have to guess or estimate on anything. I'll have exact measurements of everything you need there available for you. So don't panic. Now we have one leg elastic done. I know, like I said, it looks really funny right now, like it's not gonna work, but it will all come together. This is just one of many ways that you can do elastic in a hybrid fitted. I've done it several different ways. This is just the way I'm currently doing it. This is the way that suits me best, and I will show you why in a moment. Okay, we are almost done. Going to reposition my camera. We're going to scoot over and go to the serger. Okay, now I'm all positioned at my serger. Unfortunately, I have a short in my light, so it won't come on. Hopefully you can still see all the details and what I'm doing. Okay, so I'm going to start serging at the front panel on the very top. And keep kind of looking at the bottom fabric, the velour, because you want to make sure you're getting all three layers in your serge. Tricky part. Okay. What you're going to do is you're going to take your elastic, you're going to push it into the edge of the casing so that it's butted up against the edge of the casing. And you're going to basically hold it in place so that you can serge right there. And you want to over as far as you can so you don't accidentally cut it when you're serging. And you're going to do that all the way down. Do it again. Now, it's going to start getting closer to the other end, so what you're going to do is you're just going to pull it. so that it bunches up at the end and gives you a little bit more room to work with. And push it all the way over and do it again. And then you're gonna pull it again. And you're just gonna do that all the way down. Pull it. And get it butted up. Make sure that you don't serge it, because if you serge it into place, then it won't be able to move freely throughout the casing. Closer to the edge of the, or the end of the casing. Okay. We're done with that one, and we're gonna serge around the tab and come to the back elastic. Quick, the reason why I prefer to do my elastics this way is because when I start serging here, I can serge all the way around the whole diaper and stop at the same starting point instead of having to leave a gap to feed the elastic through or other various ways to do the elastic. Okay, so now we're at the back elastic. We're going to do the same thing. Now it might be a little bit more difficult when you get to the back elastic because it's shorter. But as soon as you can, start pulling it to give yourself a little bit more room. I'll be doing other videos showing other ways to do the elastic as well, if this is not a way that you would like to do it. This is probably a little more advanced than some of the other options. Okay. A bit of long string, really. Okay, so now here we come to the feather tab. Okay, and we're going to do the same thing with the very, very last elastic, and then when I come back, I will show you the next step. Okay, so now that we have the elastic in and it's been serged all the way around the diaper, I started here and went all the way around the entire diaper and ended here. So this is the only tail that I'll have to cut off. Now the next thing I'm going to do is add the other row of snaps. So I've already made my markings. Now I'm going to take my poker and I'm going to poke all the way through the entire diaper. Make sure you put them the opposite way of these snaps. You want the cap here and the socket here. Okay, so I'm going to do that and then we'll go on to the next step. Okay, so I've placed this row of snaps for the fold down rise so that you can make the diaper smaller for smaller babies. I also added these two snaps for my to snap in my soaker, my insert. So the next step is going to be adding the snaps for the tabs. Now, the way I do this, I'm just gonna be to line it up. I try to get it as even as I can up here. And I want the snap closer to the edge. I'm gonna take my snap and kind of test it out. And that's probably about where I'll put it. So I'm gonna make a small indentation. Take my poker, poke it through, and then add the snap. Okay. Now do the same thing for the second and the third one. And then I'll do this tab over here. Okay, so now we are ready to create the soakers that are gonna go inside our diaper. Now for me, in my particular pattern, this is just the way I do it. There are tons of ways that you can do this, and there is no right or wrong. It's just whatever you want to do. There's tons of different absorbent fabrics that you can use. And this is, once again, this is just what I use. So if you use something different, that's perfectly fine. If you want to do different layers, that's fine too. Just try it out and see what works best for you. Okay, so I have three different soakers. I have a large soaker that's going to be a snap-in. I have a small snap-in soaker, and then this is going to be the snap-in booster. Now, the top layer is a cotton fleece, and the bottom layer is bamboo fleece. Now, I'm going to also top it with cotton velour on both of these, but first, I'm going to go add snaps to these two. Okay, so we have the snaps added now. I just wanted to show you real quick my lovely, beautiful patterns for my inserts, just made out of cardboard. I just kind of came up with a size that I thought would be good for my diaper. This is what I came up with. This is for the big one. This is for the small and the booster. So basically what I do is it's about an inch down for the first, the top two snaps, and then another inch down for the bottom two snaps. And the reason why I do that is the top two snap into the diaper, and then the second row is for a number of different reasons. You can either snap the smaller soaker into the larger soaker. You could snap the booster into the smaller soaker and then into the bigger if you want all of that together. The way I do the inside of my diapers, I have an option to snap it into the back or into the front. So you could, if you have a really heavy front wetter, you could snap all of this together and then snap it into the front so that all of the absorbency is focused on the front. Maybe you have a really small baby, maybe a newborn. You could just take the booster even and just have that in there on either the front or the back, or however you want to do it. So, now that we have snaps on the soakers. I'm going to flip them over this way. I'm going to lay out the cotton velour. Just going to get it mostly lined out, lined up as good as you can. Okay, and now I'm going to go serge around all three of my soakers. Okay, all serged, all three are serged all the way around. So these two, I just have to clip the tails and they will be ready to snap in. I'm gonna go add some snaps to it real quick and I'll be right back. Okay, so I have snaps on my booster, so I can either snap it into there, or I can snap it into there, or I can save it for when I think I might need it. And that is it. Now after you get all your threads and little strings cut off, then you are completely done. And you have just made your first hybrid fitted.